Hi everyone, welcome to MyMax Academy. In this video, we'll continue with the chapter matrices from your 12th standard CBSE Mathematics. So we will start with addition of matrices. This is one of the operations that we have on matrices, that is addition of matrices. So we can add two matrices A and B. Two matrices A and B can be added if they have the same order. If A and B matrices have same order, only then the addition is defined. If not, we cannot add two matrices if their orders are not same. So for example, what is the order of this matrix? I am doing example 6 in page number 66 of your textbook. Example 6. So A matrix is given, B matrix is given, and we need to find the value of A plus B. And we can add two matrices only when the order is same. What is the order of A? 1, 2 rows and 3 columns. So 2 plus 3. B is also 2 rows and 3 columns. So 2 plus 3. Now since the order is same, 2 cross 3 and 2 cross 3. So we can add the two matrices and is defined as adding the corresponding elements. So how it is defined or how we can add two matrices is A plus B will be equal to A matrix, which is root 3, 1, minus 1, 2, 3, 0 plus B matrix, which is 2 root 5 1 minus 2 3 1 by 2. Now if you try to add them, we need to add the corresponding elements. Root 3 plus 2, so root 3 plus 2, and 1 plus root 5, 1 plus root 5, then minus 1 plus 1, minus 1 plus 1, then 2 plus minus 2, 2 plus minus 2, and 3 plus 3, then 0 plus 1 by 2. 0 plus 1 by 2. So that gives you the answer as, so this is 2 plus root 3 and this is 1 plus root 5, minus 1 plus 1 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, 3 plus 3 is 6, 0 plus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. So this is how we add, and again after you add the two matrices, the resultant matrix will be also of the same order, 2 cross 3. So we can add the two matrices only if their orders are same. If the orders are different, then we will say that the addition is not defined. The orders are different, then we cannot add two matrices. In that case, we'll say the addition is not defined. If the order is same, then we have to add the corresponding elements and we can find A plus B. This is your A plus B matrix, right? Which is our example 6. The next one is multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. Next operation is multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. When we say scalar, it means it's a number, any real number. Scalar is nothing but a number, right? So now what it means is, suppose if A is a matrix, suppose any order like 2, 3, minus 1, 5, 4, 9. Then, if I want to multiply this matrix by a scalar, which means I want to multiply this matrix by a number. Suppose if I want to find 2A matrix, multiplying the matrix A with a number. Here 2 is a number. This 2 is called a scalar. 2 is called a scalar. Scalar means it's a number, any real number. Then, how do we multiply this A with a number? So, to get 2A matrix, which means we need to multiply each element by 2. So, if A is this, and if you want to find 2A, 2A matrix, 2A is also a matrix, 2A is also a matrix. So if you want to find 2A matrix, then which means you need to multiply each element of A by this scalar 2, which is 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times minus 1 is minus 2, 2 times 5 is 10, 8 and 18. Okay, so this is how you find 2A matrix. This is called as multiplication of a matrix A by a scalar 2. Scalar means it's nothing but a number. So we are multiplying the matrix by a number, and how it is defined? It is defined like we have to multiply the each element of A with that scalar 2 to get the scalar multiplication of the matrix, which is 2A matrix. So if I want to find, suppose, minus 3A matrix, it can be negative number also. Then each number should be multiplied by minus 3. Then you get minus 6, minus 9, 3, minus 15, minus 12, minus 27. So this is your minus 3A matrix. So each element is multiplied by minus 3. Fine. So this is how we do multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. Fine. The next one that we have is negative of a matrix. Next one is called as negative of a matrix. Negative of a matrix. So what does negative of a matrix mean? Negative of a matrix mean that it is, if A is a matrix, then negative of A, negative of matrix A is defined as minus A. Negative of the matrix A is defined as minus A, which means minus 1 into A. It is also a scalar multiplication, when if the scalar is minus 1, the scalar is minus 1, which means if we find minus of A matrix, that is called as negative of the matrix A. Suppose if A matrix is this, we can take the same example. Suppose if A is this, if I want to find minus of A, negative of A, minus A. Minus A means I need to multiply each element of A with minus. So the A matrix will become minus 2, minus 3, 1, minus 5, minus 4, and minus 9. So each element should be multiplied by minus. And this minus A is called as negative of A, negative of this matrix A. Negative of this matrix A is minus A, and how that is obtained? That is obtained by multiplying the each element by minus 1 of that matrix to get the negative of a matrix. Right? The next that we have is difference of matrices. It's like a subtraction of matrices. It is called as difference of matrices. So, difference of matrices, difference of matrices. If A and B are two matrices, if A and B are two matrices, then we can find the difference between A and B, and that is defined as, if A and B are two matrices, A and B are two matrices of same order. Again, the difference is defined only if the order of A and B are same. A and B are two matrices of same order, only then you can define the difference between the two matrices, which is kind of a subtraction between two matrices. So A and B are two matrices of same order, then A minus B is defined as A plus minus B, which means we have to add the matrix A with the negative of matrix B. So A minus B, if you want to find A minus B, that is same as A plus minus of B. So first we need to find the negative of B, and then we have to add A matrix with negative of B matrix to get A minus B. You can even do directly also subtraction, that is okay, but the proper definition of the difference or subtraction of A minus B is A plus minus B. Suppose if you have a matrix A, let's take a matrix A, say 5, 2, 9, 8, and another matrix B, which is 3, 4, 6, 9. Now, if I want R, I can put minus 4. We'll have some negative numbers also. Fine. Now, if I want to find what is A plus, A minus B? Question. Then, how do you find A minus B? Is A minus B is nothing but A plus minus of B. So we write the A matrix first. What is our A matrix? A matrix is this 5, 2, 9, 8 plus, then we have to write the minus B matrix. Minus B matrix is negative of B. Negative of B is obtained by multiplying the each element of B with minus 1. So this will become minus 3. This will become plus 4. So minus 1 into minus 4 is 4. Minus 1 into 6 is minus 6. Minus 1 times minus 9 is plus 9. Then we should add these two. So if you add these two, what do we get? 5 plus minus 3 is 2. 2 plus 4 is 6. 6 plus minus 6 is 3. 8 plus 9 is 17. So this is how we find the difference between two matrices A and B. So A minus B is like, you can even directly subtract. 5 minus 3 is 2. 2 minus of minus 4 is 6. 9 minus 6 is 3. 8 minus of minus 9 is 17. We can even directly also do the subtraction, it is okay or acceptable, but the proper definition or how the difference of matrices is defined is a difference of A minus B is defined as A plus negative of B. Right? So copy this. Next, what we have is example 7. I'll do example 7 here. So example 7 is, the A matrix is given, B is given, we have to find 2A minus B. So matrix A is given as 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 1, and the matrix B is given by 3 minus 1, 3, minus 1, 0, 2. Now what we should find? We should find the value of 2A minus B. We have to find the value of 2A minus B. So find 2A minus B. So how do you find 2A minus B? So solution is, again, we have to first find 2A matrix. So, or we can directly write. So 2A minus B is nothing but 2A plus minus B matrix, right? 2A plus minus B matrix. So we have to find the 2A matrix, then we should find minus B matrix, and we should add them to get 2A minus B matrix. So what is 2A matrix? 2A matrix means I have to multiply each element by 2. So 2A matrix will become, multiply each element by 2. 2 into 1, 2. 2 2s are 4. 2 3s are 6. 2 2s are 4. 2 3s are 6. 2 1s are 2. Plus minus B. I have to multiply each element with minus 1. So you get minus 3, 1, minus 3, 1, 0, minus 2. So this is your minus B and this is your 2A. Now we should add both. So if you add them both, what do we get? So 2 minus 3 is minus 1, 4 plus 1 is 5, 6 minus 3 is 3, 4 plus 1 is 5, 6 minus 0 is 6, 2 minus 2 is 0. Fine. So this is your final answer. This is 5. So this is how we find 2A minus B matrix. Clear? So all of you can take the notes. We'll go to the next one, which is properties of matrix addition. Properties of matrix addition. Properties of matrix addition. So what are the different properties or different laws? Know that that is, you know, satisfied or obeyed by the matrix addition operation. So the first one is commutative. Commutative property or commutative law. So commutative law is, I am just telling at a very high or quick level. So commutative law is, when you have two matrices, when you add two matrices A plus B, that will be same as B plus A. So it is always true. When I add A with B, that will be same as adding B with A. So it is true for any two matrices A and B. Obviously, the order of the A and B should be same. Only then the addition is defined. So AB equal to BA. This is true for all matrices A and B. So it satisfies the commutative law, which that matrix addition satisfies commutative law. The next one is associative. Associative law. So what associative law says is, if we do A plus B plus C is same as A plus B plus C. If you want to add three matrices, then if you add A and B, then with the resultant of A and B, if you add C, that will be same as adding B and C first and then adding A with B and C. So both will be same, which means they are associative. This is true for any three matrices. Obviously, A, B, C, all three of them should be of same order. Only then the addition of matrices is defined. So this is the second law, which is associative law. The third law or the third property is existence of additive identity. So I'll say additive identity. Additive identity. So for any matrix A, right? So the additive identity. So for any matrix A of any order, the additive identity. Additive identity is zero matrix, right? It is the, you can say zero matrix. This is a zero matrix. Additive identity is, for any matrix A, the additive identity is zero, which means if you add the matrix A with the zero matrix, you will get, or if you add zero matrix with A, you will get the matrix A. You'll get back the matrix A. And that is called as existence of additive identity, which means a zero matrix exists. Zero matrix is what? Matrix with all the elements in, right? If A is any matrix of any order, then we can always find a zero matrix of the same order, such that A plus 0 will be equal to 0 plus A will be equal to A. So if you add A with zero matrix, you'll get A, or if you add zero with A matrix, you get back the same matrix A. So the zero matrix is called as the additive identity for matrices. Additive identity. Then what we have is, obviously, when once we talk about identity, we need to go to the inverse. So additive inverse. Additive inverse. And what is an additive inverse? If A is a matrix, for any matrix A, the additive inverse is minus A, which is negative of A. That is called as negative of A. Negative of matrix A. For any matrix A, the additive inverse is minus A. If any matrix is given, if they ask you to find what is the additive inverse of that matrix, you need to find the negative of that matrix, which means you need to find minus A matrix. Because if you add A matrix with minus A matrix, you will get zero matrix, which is the additive identity. Therefore, for any matrix A, the additive inverse is minus A. Right? So if you have a matrix, for example, A is minus 1, 2, 3 and 4, then for this matrix, its additive inverse is additive inverse for this matrix A will be minus A, that is 1, minus 2, minus 3 and minus 4. Because if you add both, if you try to add both, if you do A plus minus A, if you add both, you get minus 1 plus 1 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0, 3 minus 3 is 0, 4 minus 4 is 0. So you get the 0 matrix. So for any matrix A, the additive inverse for that matrix is minus A. Now next, what we have is, we have one more set of properties, that is for your scalar multiplication of matrix. Scalar multiplication, those properties of scalar multiplication of a matrix. So properties of scalar multiplication of a matrix. So what it says is, the first property is, we have only two properties, which is K times A plus B, where K is some number. K is not a matrix. A and B are matrices. K is some number. So, I will put the small k. Right? So, Ka is defined as Ka plus Kb, where K is any number, any scalar. This is always true. Which means, example is, if you want to find, suppose, 2 times of A plus B, that is same as 2A plus 2B. Your K here is 2. That's a scalar, which is a number. And second property, what it is if you have, suppose, K plus L, where K and L both are scalars. When I write it in small letters, they are scalars. And this is A. This is same as K times A plus L times A. K times A plus L times A. This is always true. So, what it means is, suppose if you have 2 plus 3 of A, it can be written as 2 times A plus 3 times A. This is always true. Example is, if you have 2 plus 3, your K is 2, L is 3, then 2 plus 3 of A is a matrix that is same as 2 times A plus 3 times A. So, which is this? K plus L of A is K A plus L A. So, this is always true. Fine. Now, we will go to the example 8. So, what is example 8? So, example 8, I will continue from here. If you can take the notes. So, what we have is example 8. Example 8 is A is 8, 0, 4, minus 2, 3, 6 and B is another matrix which is 2, minus 2, 4, 2, minus 5, 1. This is how A and B matrices are given. Find the matrix X such that. So, we have to find X. Find the matrix X such that 2A plus 3X equal to 5B. And we need to find the value of the matrix X such that this condition is satisfied, which is 2A plus 3X is equal to 5B. We need to find the value of matrix X. So, again, the solution is, we write this equation 2A plus 3X equal to 5B. This is given. We have to find the value. What is the matrix? See here, A, X, B, all three are matrices. A and B are given. We need to find X. So, then we will solve this using the normal way. Like how we try to solve a linear equations in equation in one variable. Right? So, we need to move this to the other side. So, you get 2a, right? Then your x becomes 1 by 3 of 5b minus 2a. Now, your x matrix is what? 1 by 3 of 5b minus 2a. We have to find the matrix 5b minus 2a and then we have to do 1 by 3 of that. So, your x becomes 1 by 3 of, this is a bracket, not a, you know, a bracket for the matrix. This is not a bracket for the matrix. So, bracket for the multiplication. So, 1 by 3 of, fine, 1 by 3 of 5b. So, 5 into matrix B. Matrix B is 2 minus 2, 4, 2 minus 5, 1 minus 2 times A matrix. A is 8, 0, 4 minus 2, 3 and 6. Now, what it becomes? So, 1 by 3 of, now 5a means 5, sorry, 5b means you need to multiply each element by 5. So, it will become 10, 10, this is a bracket, 10 minus 10, 5 fours are 20, 10 minus 25, 5 plus, I am going to multiply this with minus 2, I am going to take minus 2 inside. So, this will become plus. Or you can just take 2 alone here and then keep minus here, or we can multiply with minus 2 and then put it as plus. So, you have to be careful here. So, multiply, I am going to multiply with minus 2. So, this will become plus because before this you have a plus. And so, minus 2 into 8 is minus 16, 0, 4 times minus 2 is minus 8, 2 2s are 4 plus 2 minus 6 minus 12. Clear? So, now we will have to add them. We will have to add them. So, that is 1 by 3 of add them. So, if you add the matrices, 10 minus 6, 16 is minus 6, 10 minus 0 is minus, 10 plus 0 is minus 10, then 20 minus 8 is 12, 10 plus 4 is 14, minus 25 minus 6 is minus 31, 5 minus 12 is minus 7. 5 minus 12 is minus 7. So finally, what do we get? Now we need to multiply each element by 3. So if you do that, finally, so we get, and I can write it here. So the value of this whole thing will be equal to minus 6 by 3. So each element should be multiplied with 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 into minus 6 is minus 2. Then 1 by 3 into minus 10 is minus 10 by 3. Right? Then 1 by 3 into 12 is 4. 1 by 3 into 14 is 14 by 3. Then minus 31 by 3. Minus 7 by 3. So this is your matrix X. This is your matrix X such that it satisfies the condition 2A plus 3X equal to 5. So this is your matrix X. And so this is the answer. Fine. All of you can take the notes there. Then I will go to the next problem, which is example 9. Example 9. So what example 9 says is, find the value of X and Y, where find the matrix as X and Y, where X plus Y is given as X plus Y equal to 5, 2, 0, 9, and X minus Y is given as 3, 6, 0, minus 1. Now we have to find the value of the matrix X and matrix Y. Now we can do this using our normal way of solving the linear equations in two variables, pair of linear equations in two variables. We can use by elimination method. So if I add both, then minus plus X minus Y plus Y minus Y will get cancelled. X plus X will become 2X. So here the capital X and Y are matrices, not numbers. So now we have to add these two. So 5 plus 3 is 8. 2 plus 6 is 8, 0, this is also 8, 9 minus 1. So your X becomes 1 by 2 of 8, 8, 0, 8. So your X will become, if you multiply each element with 1 by 2, you get 4, 4, 0, 8. So this is your X, 4, 4, 0, 4. So this is your X matrix. Now we have found the X matrix. Now we need to find the matrix Y. So to find the matrix Y, what we can do, we can either substitute the X matrix in one of the equations and find Y, or we can even, you know, subtract these two equations and find Y. Either case, so we will substitute this. So substituting X as this in this, so X plus Y is 5209. So my Y will be, I'll substitute the X now. So substituting X, X is 4404 plus Y equal to 5209. Fine. So that becomes, if I write it here, my Y equal to, so this will go to the other side. So you get 5209, which is this, minus this one, 4404. This minus 4404. So what do we get? Y as Y equal to, you can directly subtract, 5 minus 4 is 1, 2 minus 4 is minus 2, 0 minus 0 is 0, 9 minus 4 is 5. So your Y is 1, minus 2, 0 and 5. So that is all. So you found your X matrix and Y matrix. So this is your answer. X and Y. Clear? So this is how we find the two matrices X and Y, says that X plus Y is this and X minus Y is this. So right? All of you can take the notes. I will go to the next example, which is example 10. So example 10. So what it says is, we have to find the value of X and Y. We have to find the value of X and Y such that 2 times X, 5 7y minus 3 plus 3 minus 4, 1 and 2 equal to 7, 6, 15 and 14. Now, we need to find the value of x and y. We need to find the value of x and y. So, now we will add these two. We will multiply this matrix with 2 and add with this. Then it will become one matrix. Then this matrix will be equal to this matrix. When two matrices are equal, then the corresponding elements are equal. We can equate the corresponding elements and find the value of x and y. So, that's how we are going to do this. Fine. So, now, so if you do this, 2 into this will give you 2x. 10, multiplying each element with 2. So, 2 into x, 2x, 2 into 5, 10. 2 times 7 is 14. This will become 2y minus 6 plus 3 minus 4, 1, 2 equal to 7, 6, 15, 14. Now, add them. 2x plus 3. So, this implies, not equal to, implies because we already have an equal to here. So, this implies 2x plus 3, then 10 minus 4 is 6, 14 plus 1 is 15, 2y minus 6 plus 2 is 2y minus 4, 2y minus 6 plus 2 will become 2y minus 4 equal to 7, 6, 15, 14. Now, we have to equate, you know, the two matrices are equal, therefore the corresponding elements are also equal, so which means 2x plus 3 is equal to 7, this is equal to 7, this 6 is matching, 15, 15 is matching. So, this 2y minus 4 should be equal to, or I can write the other equation here, 2y minus 4 is equal to 14. Now, solve this, so you get 2x is equal to 7 minus 3, so 2x is 4, x is 2. So, similarly, 2y equal to 14 plus 4, so 2y is 18, y is 9. So, your answer is x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 9. So, your final answer is x is equal to 2, comma y is equal to 9. So, this is how we find the value of x and y. Fine. So, all of you copy this. Then, I will go to example 11. Now, what is example 11? So, example 11 is, it's a case study problem. It's a case study problem where a scenario is given, and based on the given scenario, you need to answer the questions. So, what is given is, example 11 is two farmers, Ram Kishan and Guru Charan Singh, they cultivate only three varieties of rices, namely Basmati, Perumal and Naura. The sale in rupees of these varieties of rice by both the farmers in the month of September and October are given by the following matrices A and B. So, there is a matrix that is given A, which says it is 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, 50,000, 30,000. And 10,000. So, this is the September sales of three varieties of rice. The rices are Basmati, Perumal and Naura. Three varieties of rices. This is the September sales. September month sales. September sales in rupees. September sales in rupees done by two farmers, Ram Kishan. Ram Kishan and Guru Charan Singh. Guru Charan Singh. So these two farmers, they produce or they cultivate three varieties of rices, and this is the sales figure for the September month, which means farmer Ram Kishan had sold basmati rice of rupees 10,000. So he has made money of 10,000 rupees by selling the price for 10,000 rupees. Then the sale, the Perumal, his sale was 20,000 for Perumal variety, and for Naura his sale was 30,000. Similarly for Gurcharan Singh, 50,000 for Basmati, Perumal is 30,000 sales and 10,000 sales for Naura for the month of September. So this is how the sales figure for the month of September, and matrix B denotes the October sales. Again it is 5,000, 10,000, 6,000, 20,000, 10,000, 10,000. It is for October. October month sales in rupees. So what it says is, again, no, the same Basmati rice, Ram Kishan sold 5,000 rupees of Basmati rice, 10,000 rupees he sold the sale for Perumal was 10,000 rupees. The sale that he had for the Naura variety of rice in the month of October was 6,000. Similarly for Gurcharan, 20,000, 10,000 and 10,000 for the three varieties of rice respectively for the month of October. Now this is a given situation or scenario, and we have to answer three questions. The first question is solution. First part, what we need to find is, find the combined sales in September and October for each farmer in each variety. Now, what is the combined sale? So, what is the total sale for the month of September and October for both the farmers for each variety of rice? So, for that, we need to add the matrices A and B. So, combined sales in September and October. September and October for each farmer, for each variety is given by the matrix, sum of the matrix A plus B. We have to add the matrices A and B. So if you add the matrices, what do we get? So we have to add these two matrices, and we can add them because they have the same order. The order for this is 2 cross 3, this is also a 2 cross 3 matrix. We can add. So adding corresponding elements. So 10,000 plus 5,000, 15,000. Then 30,000. 20 plus 10, 30 plus 6 is 36,000. Then 70,000. Then 30 plus 10 is 40,000. Then 10,000 plus 10,000 is 20,000. So this is the total sale of the rice by both the farmers, so which is Ram Kishan. Ram Kishan and Gurcharan Singh. Gurcharan Ramcharan and Gurcharan Singh for the rices Basmati, Perumal and Naura. The three varieties of rice, what is the combined sale for September and October, which means you have to add the two matrices A and B. So that will give you the first part, answer to the first part. The second part is, the second question is, find the decrease in sales from September to October. You have to find the decrease in sales from September to October, which means how much sale has been reduced compared to September. In October, how much it has decreased. So to find the decrease in sales, for example, this Ram Kishan made 10,000, he sold Basmati rice for 10,000 rupees in September, but whereas in October he sold only 5,000 rupees of same Basmati. So which means there is a reduction of 5,000 rupees. The sale in September was 10,000, but sale in October was 5,000. So how much sale is reduced? Which means you have to find the difference between this minus this, A minus B. So he had sold it for 10,000 in September, the Basmati rice, but in October he could sell only 5,000 rupees of Basmati. So there is a reduction of 5,000 rupees, which is 10,000 minus 5,000. So his sale went down by 5,000. So similarly here it is 20 minus 10 will be 10, 30, and he could sell only 6,000 in October. So the reduction in sale will be 30,000 minus 6,000.
which is 24,000
is the reduction in sale. So to find the decrease in sale, you have to subtract. So decrease in sale from September to October is given by the difference of A minus B matrix. Now what is A minus B? So we need to subtract. So if you subtract both A and B, so 10,000 minus 5,000 is 5,000. Then 20 minus 10 is 10. Then 30 minus 6 is 24,000. Then again 5,000 minus, sorry, 50 minus 20 is 30. Fine, then 30 minus 10 is 20. Then this is 10,000 minus 10,000 is 0. So this is the decrease in sale for the rice basmati, and this is Permal and Navra by the farmer Ram Kishan and Gurcharan Singh. So this is the decrease in sale compared from September to October. Sale reduced by 5,000 for Basmati, for Permal it is 10,000, it is reduced. For Navra it is reduced by 24,000. Similarly for the other farmer Gurcharan Singh also, the Basmati reduced in sale is 30,000, 20,000, and for the last variety there was no reduce in sale because he had sold 10,000 in the month of September and he also sold the same 10,000 rupees in October as well. Thus, therefore there is no decrease in sale, so it is zero. So this answers the second part of the question. Now we'll go to the third part. The third part of the question. So third part is the continuation of this. The third part is, it says, if both the farmers receive 2% profit on gross sales, compute the profit for each farmer and for each variety of rice sold in October. Suppose if the gross profit, the profit that they are going to make by selling this much amount of, you know, rice of each variety, they are getting 2% profit based on 2% of the sales. That will be their profit. So this is the selling price. Their profit is 2% of the selling price. So we need to find how much profit both the farmers made for each variety of rice for the month of October we have to find. So which means this is the October sales figure. And we need to find the profit for the month of October for each variety of rice by each farmer. And we know the profit is given as 2% of the sales in October. Profit in October is 2% of the sales in October. So which means we should find 2% of B matrix, right? So it is, so sale, sorry, profit, right? Profit on gross sale. Compute the profit of each. So profit is given by profit for October. It's for the month of October. Profit for October, because we need to calculate only for October. Profit for October is given by 2% of B. We have to find 2% of matrix B because the profit is 2% of the sales. Profit is 2%. So we should find 2% of B, that is equal to 2% means 2 by 100 of B matrix. That is equal to 2 by 100 of what is our B matrix? 5,000, 10,000, 6,000, right? Then 20,000, 10,000, and 10,000. Now let's do this. So 2 by 100 of this. So 20 will get cancelled. 2 times 50 will give you 100. Then here double 0 goes. 2 times 100 is 200. Then double 0 goes. 2 times 60 is 120. Then 100, 2 by 100 into this. So you have to multiply each element by 2 by 100. Double 0 goes. 2 times 200 is 400. 2 times 100 is 200. Again 2 times 100 is 200. Clear? So now, so this is for the farmer Ram Kishan And this is for Gurcharan Singh. Right? And this is for the three varieties of rice, which are Basmati, Permal, and Naura. So this is the profit. This is the profit matrix. So which means, so we will write in October, Ramkishan, in October, the farmer Ramkishan received rupees 100, comma rupees 200, comma rupees 120, 100, 200 and 120 as a profit in the sale of each variety of rice respectively, which means he received 100 rupees as profit for Basmati, 200 as profit for Permal, and 120 as profit for Naura. So similarly, we can say and the other farmer, so respectively. Then in October, Gurcharan Singh, the farmer Gurcharan Singh received rupees 400, comma rupees 200, comma rupees 200 as profit in the sale of each variety of rice respectively. Fine. So which means Gurcharan Singh received 400 rupees profit for Basmati, 200 for Permal, and 200 for Naura for the month of October. Fine. So this is how we do this. So you can take the notes. I will stop the video here and you can watch my video for the continuation of this. Thank you for watching, guys. See you in the next video. Thank you.